proposed to not allow student IDs for voting.
And that makes the students go to the risk of a higher all air on the website.
Public broadcasting studios on the campus of Washington State University. This is Murrow News.
Good afternoon. I'm Brinkley Hill.
And I'm Austin Peppers. Welcome to Murrow News 8. The Idaho House of Representatives passed a bill on Monday that finalizes local governments who won't enforce state felonies. The bill HB 22 directs tax commission to withhold sales from local entities who pass a formal resolution to not fully enforce state felonies, but doesn't affect federal crimes or Second Amendment sanctuary cities.
As shoplifting continues to be an issue on campus, we sent our local reporter, Nick Beck, to go and check in on local convenience stores.
All right, guys, outside Box, which is a very common grocery store on campus, convenience store, and they've been having a big issue of shoplifting lately, and one thing students may not be aware of is there is a $200 shopping fee for students that shoplift. So next time you're going into the grocery store, make sure you give that a second thought. Back to you guys at the desk.
As a reminder to our viewers, Vitalant is still hosting a blood drive, and amidst the national shortage, it's more important now than ever. Every 2 seconds, someone in the U.S. needs blood, and a single donation could save up to 3 lives. For more information or to set up a donation appointment, visit Vitalant.org.
Idaho legislature proposed Monday to no longer allow student IDs as a form of voter identification. Representative Tina Lambert proposed the bill, concerned for out-of-state students with mail-in ballots from states like Washington or Oregon. Those students are able to also vote by mail and also allow their student IDs to vote in person in a second state committing voter fraud. This offense is punishable up to 14 years in jail or fine up to $50,000.
Cougs help Cougs everywhere, including in the Grand Canyon. Alana Duval and Johanna Ludwig were 4 days into a 10-day hike they were leading when they came across a distraught hiker named Lauren. She was weak and mildly disoriented, but Duval and Ludwig were prepared to help with their training through the Outdoor Recreation Center and got a search and rescue team on the way. The hiking group made Lauren comfortable and monitored her condition while they waited.
After the break, an inside look at the new minimum wage.
And the end of a cold spell in Coleman here on Murrow News 8.
One drink can bring back a baby. One drink, that means a good baby. Your favorite brother. Your own brother. You can break your football brother. Your future brother. The boss's mother. If one and three doesn't count to you, that means it could be two. Your mother. Your father's mother.
And square.
Next. You. Your plumber. Your plumber's medicine.
Yeah.
You. Your dog walker. Your cat slut. Or you. Your co-pilot. Your co-pilot's co-pilot. One and three events have screwed up babies. When only diagnostics, screwed up babies can be reversed. Take the risk test at doiheadscreeddiabetes.org to help avoid this.
On January 1st, Washington's minimum wage went up. Murrow News reporter Damian Alvarado looked to see how it will impact the community.
When I did find out how much more I would be making, it was really impactful for me. I did not know it was going to be that large of a margin.
The Washington minimum wage increased to $15.74 an hour, making it the highest in the nation. This is a whole $1.25 from the previous year. Manager of South Fork, Joshua Rockwell, shares just how his employees have reacted.
I think everybody that got it was pretty excited just at the fact that, you know, for every hour worked, they're going to make a couple extra.
Labor costs can account for 70% of total business costs. Joshua says he has to be creative in order to be efficient when handling the increase.
But one of the biggest things was just being able to be efficient with our staffing.
There's been an 8% increase in inflation across the United States. But Washington's new minimum wage increase at 8%, that helps combat some of those costs. So people like Lauren Potowski, who work at Southside Cafe, are able to have a little bit of extra cash to their pocket.
and now I've been able to afford all of my needs, and I can also like cut back on my hours because I don't need to work as much. Making more money is something that I'm really glad about.
Economic professor Christopher Clark shares why the increase is beneficial rather than harmful.
Well, the cost of living in employment is so much less than Seattle. So 1574 goes a lot further than it does there. And therefore, if you have a job here and you're making 1574, you're going to be a lot, it's going to help you out a lot more to cover your cost of living.
So will it have a negative impact on Pullman?
Not too much. It's not going to be a large effect. And we know that there are significant positive effects for those who are trying to make a living.
Jim in Alvarado, Murrow, New Jersey.
President Joe Biden announced that he will end the twin national emergencies for COVID-19 on May 11th. With the world returning to normalcy about 3 years after the emergency was announced, this move restructures the coronavirus response to treat it as an endemic threat, which can be managed through agencies' normal authorities. Speaking of normalcy, Celine, I heard that it's supposed to get warmer this week.
Yeah, Austin, that is absolutely right. It is going to get warmer, but we're still in winter. It's not the warmest yet. But you know what? It is definitely an improvement from yesterday's absolutely freezing single digits. Some flurries just finished coming down tonight. So just remember, if you have any fun plans, it should be nice and dry for you this evening. Our low, I wish it wasn't as low, but we will take it for the time being. And just looking at tomorrow, it is going to be a whole lot more beautiful, and we're not going to get snow like we did today, so that is a plus. And I know for all of you guys who are sick and tired of winter, there is some sunshine on the horizon because our sunset tonight is setting at 4:52. I know that doesn't sound great, but it's a two-minute increase from yesterday, and those 2 minutes are eventually going to add up, and spring will be here before we know it. I can feel it. Just focus on those beautiful sunshiny days we're going to have soon because that's what's getting me through this week. And just taking a look at our next map here. So we have some beautiful weather on the west side. I am so jealous. I wish that we had some of that sunshine here, like we have in Olympia and in Seattle even. Coming over to Yakima, they're not too different from our weather here. Same with Tri-Cities. Obviously, it's going to be more cold in Pullman and Spokane, but we're just going to go ahead and take a look at our next map. So with our five-day forecast here in Pullman, we are going to definitely get warmer. Like I said, there's good news on the horizon. Just stick it out for the snow that we'll be getting tonight. And back to you guys in the studio.
When we come back, the WC Women's basketball team has had some national recognition.
And an inside look at the WC Athletic Training Department here.
Good evening, I'm Damon Alvarado with sports. We see the athletes on screen, but our reporter Alexander Huddleston takes us behind the scenes to see how athletic trainers do their job.
Which eventually led to his full recovery at a local hospital. The athletic training department here at WCU, led by Casey Hildenbrand, is well prepared for emergency situations such as with the Mahan event.
Reaction plans are something that our students are very well within. Every location, every event has an emergency action plan.
According to Kira McDonald, a third year in the program, these emergency action plans are an accumulation of multiple different skill sets practiced by the students on a daily basis.
We practice things like emergency procedures and CPR and AED utilization over and over and over again until we get to the point where if something happens, we're not really worried about the crowd, we're not really worried about how high stakes it is, about the TV or the cameras on us. we can focus and calm one, make sure we're grabbing the best like, high level care to the person that's injured.
You know, when an athlete goes down, an athlete carries a little fix you up. Thanks, Wes.
Wesley Taylor is a first year student in the program. He currently is working as the athletic trainer for the WCU rowing team. Training says that as a first year, he is already getting hands-on training.
As a first year in the program, we are starting to learn how to communicate with the athletes, work modalities with athletes, and work with our peers, like any certified athletic trainers, and the physicians that we work with, and getting more exposed into the field.
Holden Band believes that with the open media coverage of the DeMar Hamlin case, it may help shed some light on the importance of athletic trainers.
I think the opportunity is for people to realize the importance of athletic trainers, and, you know, a lot of times they're like, oh, you just take people to drink water, and we know how to brace, you know, and tape and appropriately deal with, repeated injuries, and we can also make sure that you're properly hydrated and do that sort of stuff, but we're also there in case things go really wrong.
For those sports fans, the heroes wear jerseys. However, the real truth to service are those who stare at the sideline or benches, waiting to jump into action in the case that one of our heroes goes to
hard the shot.
Reporting in Pullman, Alexander Harrison, Maryland.
Thank you, Alex. It's always interesting to see people behind the scenes. But on to women's basketball. The Cougs' road wins against ASU and 19th-ranked Arizona gives WCU its second top 25 road win this season. NCAA.com named WSU Team of the Week after their impressive weekend. The Cougs have not beaten both schools on the road since the 2012-2013 season, this making it the second time in 3 weeks where WSU has beaten a ranked opponent. On the road, here's what Coach Cam Yethridge had to say after that victory.
Into this place, you know, with a hard-fought win. Another splash celebration, unfortunately, that whoever made up that celebration is awful, but I'm so excited for this team, walking into this place, you know, with a hard-fought win.
Speaking of big wins and Team of the Week, Etheridge made a splash in the headlines yesterday as ESPN.com named her Coach of the Week. She led the Cougs to a 15-6 record this season and will look to defend home court against number 2-ranked Stanford Cardinal Friday at 7 p.m. Well, that wraps up sports. We'll have more for you guys after the break.
Thanks for watching. If you miss anything in this or any of our previous newscasts, you can always watch us on our YouTube channel.
Our news can be found at nwp.org/nwp. You can follow us.